Hey everyone, welcome back to Poplar Preparedness. We got a lot of stuff to cover here. I went to the stores today and a lot of stuff was kind of wiped out. A lot of the store shelves look like they're ransacked. We got a bunch of shortages to talk about. You're going to want to see this for yourself. Just be keeping in mind. And we also have a great deal out there on Keystone beef out there. And I was checking to see if it is elsewhere. And it is more widespread than just my area. So you might be able to pick up some Keystone beef for a nice discount too. Lots of stuff to talk about. Let's jump right into the pictures. Folks, no rotisserie chicken at the Sam's Club. Yeah, we're seeing this more and more. Just seems like they're always out nowadays. There were some other things at Sam's Club that looked a little off, but other than that, let's get over to Walmart. But first, this video is brought to you by Genesis Gold Group. If you have retirement funds that you want to get out of stocks and bonds into physical gold, physical silver, physical platinum, you want to talk to these guys. Jonathan and his team are fantastic. They'll answer all your questions and help you make that transition to something more stable if you like. You can find them down in the description below or give that number a call. All right, folks, over at Walmart, we're seeing whipped topping. Anything that's cream-based, anything that's just heavy milk fats, we're just seeing issues. And we've been seeing issues for quite a while. Coffee creamers and whipped toppings and all that kind of stuff. Also, we're just seeing issues with just the regular breakfast materials, breakfast foods and pancakes and sausages and all that kind of stuff like that. We just continue to have issues with that. They just can't seem to get these things in stock. Frozen potatoes continue to be an issue, of course, because of the bad harvests out west in the United States and, of course, up in Canada. And, of course, those issues with some of those diseases spreading potatoes-wise. So the harvest has been light the last couple years. This year was a little bit better, but it was still underperforming and definitely did not pick up the slack from the very bad year we had the prior year. So frozen potatoes continue to be an issue. When I was here at the Walmart, it was just like potatoes as well as the pizzas. And I mean, look, even the ho-hos were all like hit hard, right? We had just snack cakes and everything like that. And I don't usually order or buy these sugar formed sugar items. But if you're into that sort of thing, also notice that the generic items are the first to disappear. That's kind of par for the course, I guess, but just not restocking. And also, of course, with the vegetables, so not just the ho-hos, but also the Brussels sprouts and the spinach. A lot of the frozen vegetables were hit hard, just ransacked. Of course, the coffee creamers, the powdered coffee creamers are, you know, drawn down pretty significantly. Coffee looked fairly well, but again, look at those generics. The generics, the cheaper options out there were the hardest hit there. But plenty of coffee if you do want it, but certain varieties are gone. So if you're looking for certain varieties. Now, this whole section here, just a couple weeks ago, was all K-cups, and now it's bags of coffee. I don't know if they're having issues sourcing the K-cups, the plastic and foil or whatever, but it does seem like K-cups are kind of disappearing real fast. I don't know if it's just because people are starting to make more economical decisions. I think K-cups are extremely wasteful, generally speaking, but I mean, you know, if you need to do that in order to get your work done or whatever, because it's more efficient for you, then cool. But it's a lot cheaper to buy it in bulk form or powdered form and, you know, use a drip coffee maker or something like that. Or you can just refill your own K-cups. There's some reusable K-cups that you can put coffee in. Anyway, vinegar looked, you know, better than what I've seen the last number of weeks. So they seem to be fairly well off that way. Lots of pinto beans, folks. You know, there is time to stock up still. Look at all those pinto beans on the shelf. That's going to be your biggest hurdle because it's more expensive than the rice. To stock up on pinto beans, that costs more. So you can definitely stock up on pinto beans. Rice, you know, generic rice is starting to be a little harder to find. The last number of times I've been there, they've had a 20-pounder, like this time. There's a 20-pounder generic, and then there's no smaller bags. No smaller bags. Now, the 20 pounders are the cheapest way to stock up, and that's the way to go. But, you know, you're going to need a bunch of 20 pounders, you know, and then repackage them into Mylar in buckets. Or if necessary, just put them in buckets. It won't last as long for sure, but make sure you do freeze whatever you get to make sure that any bugs or eggs inside there are killed off. Ketchup looked a little more ransacked than what I'm used to seeing, but, you know, once again, if you need ketchup, period, you're going to find ketchup. Now, look at this, though. All the multi-packs of canned chicken gone. All of them. That's just, I haven't seen that for a few weeks, and that is troubling, folks. I've been telling you to invest in chick coin for quite a bit now. Not Bitcoin, chick coin, and that is canned chicken, because that's going to be worth a ton, folks. When the multi-packs disappear like that, how long do you think those cans, those individual cans of chicken are going to last? They're going to disappear real fast. Hopefully they can get restocked. But let me know if you're seeing canned chicken disappearing out where you are as well. A lot of other stuff disappearing, especially those Vienna sausages. But here's a bright spot of hope here. Check that out. This is a sale of Keystone beef, $8.94. It's been $9.99 for quite a while. So it coming down to $8.94 is very good. I did check on the Walmart website, and I did find that it seems to be $8.94 on the website as well. I've heard from a few of you that it's a little cheaper than that even elsewhere. Now, I haven't been able to verify that independently, but you might want to check to see if you can get Keystone beef at this discounted rate. I don't know how long that's going to last, or if their supplies are limited or whatever. But be aware that if you order off Walmart.com, these bigger cans have a tendency to get dented. So I don't know if they just pull the dented ones and give them to the people that are ordering offline, or if they get dented in the shipping and stuff like that. So please, please, please try to get it in person if you can, so you can make sure your cans aren't dented. Or if you do order online, don't be shy. If they come dented, you start a return process and either take them into the Walmart, take the dented ones in and show them and give them. Sometimes what they'll do is they'll just send you replacements and let you keep the dented cans. Don't abuse that, please. But, you know, that has happened before with canned goods. Yeah. But Vienna sausages, those were also hard hit. So that's something to look at too. Vienna sausages are much better to get shipped to you because they don't get dented as easily. Tuna was also drawn down pretty significantly. It looked like the Starkist got hit pretty hard, and then maybe they, you know, probably what happened, and this is just me reading between the lines here, they probably ran out of great value tuna, and then people started buying the Starkist because the great value tuna was gone, and then they probably brought out a bunch more cans of great value, and that's kind of why you see this kind of discrepancy, because normally the generic goes first. Or maybe someone found a bunch of coupons on Starkist tuna. If that's the case, let me know about that. But anyway, mashed potatoes, that's been kind of an issue for a while. It's still there. Where's all the generic packets of mashed potatoes? Idahoan and Hungry Jack and Betty Crocker, but no, just a couple packets there of generic baked mashed potatoes. Tomato sauce definitely seemed to be drawn down pretty significantly. That looks pretty pulled over, doesn't it? There's a lot of holes there. Sorry, went the wrong way. And then this is a little further down the aisle. I was so shocked I started doing like a panorama kind of thing because all the spaghetti sauces, what's up with that? That's just crazy. And of course, the pasta didn't look much better. It looked like they just got some more pasta and put that in there. But normally, if they only had that much pasta, they would have fronted it. So this does look like it just hasn't been restocked at all or fronted. Looks like people started going on a buying frenzy. But pasta is down a good bit. We'll see what restocking looks like. Other areas of pasta here. Some issues there. And then, of course, your Norris sides and all that kind of stuff, definitely drawn down. vegetable oil drawn down. A lot less vegetable oil. That looks like a restocking issue. People don't tend to, you know, buy a bazillion jugs of soybean oil unless somebody's doing like some kind of scientific experiment or something that requires, like, you know, Mr. Beast came in and decided to buy, you know, like 900 gallons of soybean oil or something like that. Vegetable oil, it seems to be all what got pulled down. And they seem to restock some canola oil, but they didn't seem to restock any vegetable oil. The Criscos seem to be still half decent there, but if you're gonna make your Crisco candle, you might want to grab some soon. Notice how the generic Crisco is not on the shelf. Oatmeal, not a lot there, but you're gonna see over at Aldi the oatmeal was there pretty good. So if you need oatmeal and you can't find it at Walmart, you might want to go over to Aldi. They seem to be doing a little better on that. Everyone's staying home and making pancakes, apparently. I don't know. We have the syrup. There's a lot less syrup out there. Eggs are $3.67 at a dozen at Walmart. You're going to see that that's cheaper than Aldi, and that has been going on, at least in my area, for a bit. So if you're looking for eggs for cheap, you might be able to save a little more money at Walmart than at Aldi. Egg section looked actually fairly well stocked, but at those prices, you need a goose that lays you a golden egg. Things that require eggs, like cookie dough and everything like that, seem to be drawn down a little bit. And, of course, the creams, issues there. There's less variety. The hell of a good dip. Notice it's all French onion. That's it. There's no variety of that. Usually they have, like, three or four different varieties, but now it's just French onion. So be aware of that. Just any of the creams, any of the heavy creams. The iced teas got hammered pretty hard. They just not getting restocked. I don't know if a truck just didn't come in or what, but that's not how that usually looks. And in the cream section, that's worst I've seen in the last number of weeks. Coffee creamers, same deal, just not restocked. Milk section looked a little bit better, but still definitely some issues there. Cheeses, not so bad, but when you get into the lunch meats look worse. Sausages, I mean, a lot of the big packs got ransacked as well, not the smaller packs, and of course the generics seem to be gone. Frozen chickens seem to be drawn down a bit. Just a couple bags left of wings. Is the Super Bowl coming up? Oh, gosh. I sound like I'm out of it, don't I? I don't even know when the Super Bowl is. Maybe it's the Super Bowl that everyone's buying wings for. I don't know. Most of the chicken actually seemed to be pretty well stocked. Now, at those prices, once again, that's like $3 a pound. When you can get chicken breasts for $2.97 a pound, and you can get ground beef chubs for like $2.60. The fact that ground beef is cheaper than chicken breast just is, you know, mind-boggling to me. Over to Aldi, $4.44 for eggs here. Significantly cheaper, 80 cents cheaper to get them at Walmart. So be aware of that, folks. And also be aware that if you go just two doors to the right, you can get free-range large brown eggs for $4.19 instead of the $4.44 for regular eggs. So get you some free-range eggs if you're going to be at Aldi, or get yourself over to Walmart if you're willing to support the corporate takeover of America. Anyway, we have some generic instant mashed potatoes here, but you better like buttery, because that's the only option you got at Aldi. We've been seeing this for a number of weeks. They seem to only have one option, or they don't have any options at all on the generic instant mashed potato packets. They seem to be better stocked with a lot of stuff, but definitely some areas like egg noodles, mac and cheese, regular mac and cheese, not really all that much. Also, they seem to be out of ramen, and you know how sensitive I am about ramen. Walmart looked fine on ramen, but when normal people panic and they start, quote unquote, prepping in their mind, they start buying ramen. So that's why I'm always kind of looking at ramen to see if the masses have started panicking. All right, over to the frozen section. Chicken wings over here, again, and chicken tenderloins. Some of the chicken products seem to be gone. So be, once again, maybe the Super Bowls, that's what everyone's stocking up for. Anyway, potatoes, frozen potatoes over at Aldi, also an issue. And that's what I got for you folks. If you have an update, use the word update in your comment and some sort of geographical location. Let us know what you're missing in your area. Thanks so much for watching. There's a video on the screen. I can see you over there, or I'll see you guys later. Steve Poplar out.